Wait, you want me to strain whiskey through cottage cheese?
And that's gonna make it clear?
What the fuck?
Happy happy hour.
I'm Dave, the basement bartender.
I've got the perfect cocktail to help you ring in the new year.
The Milk Clarified New York Sour is not only stunning in a glass,
not only delicious,
but it's got a crazy technique behind it that will turn brown whiskey into a clear liquid with a silky velvet-like texture.
What's the secret?
Legend. Wait for it. And I hope you're not lactose intolerant because the second half of that word is dairy.
Let's get this thing started.
Basement bartender.
A traditional sour is composed of a spirit, citrus, and sugar.
Sours include a wide range of classics, including the daiquiri, margarita, and of course the whiskey sour.
The New York sour updates the traditional whiskey sour by floating red wine on top.
The New York sour goes back as far as 1870 with different names, such as the continental sour.
So what's continental then?
Mm-hmm. Start off with 2.5 ounces of rye or bourbon whiskey.
Rye will feature more prominent spices than bourbon will. Both are fantastic choices as long as they are very high proof.
The clarification process will tone down the flavor.
So the higher the proof, the more we'll actually taste the whiskey in the final product.
Roll and squeeze half of a medium-sized lemon to yield about 1 ounce of lemon juice.
Add 3/4 ounce of simple syrup, which is equal parts sugar and water,
and stir over ice for 25 revolutions.
Thus far, we've made a whiskey sour.
If we were to strain this over ice and float red wine or port on top, it would be a New York sour.
But I promised you a milk clarified New York sour.
Yes, science!
Pour this mixture into 1 ounce of whole milk.
Side note, when milk clarifying,
always pour the drink into milk with at least 3.5% fat content.
When the milk mixes with the acid, it curdles and essentially turns into a boozy cottage cheese.
Cheese from some cottage? Who's cottage? What is that exactly?
When we pass the curdled cocktail through a funnel and coffee filter,
the curds stay behind, trapping particulates.
The initial pass won't be as clear as it could be.
After about 60 seconds of the initial pass,
pour the cloudy liquid back into the funnel and coffee filter, allowing it to go through again.
The curds have now had an opportunity to settle, and the remaining results will be much clearer.
It can take a long time to filter the entire drink.
But here's the good news.
The clarification process acts as a preservative.
A clarified cocktail can be stored at cellar temperatures
for months.
But once it's done, you end up with a stunningly beautiful, clear cocktail.
Pour it over a clear ice block and top it off by adding 3/4 ounce of a dry red wine over the back of your bar spoon.
This is called floating.
Using the spoon to slow and spread the wine before it makes contact with the rest of the drink
will keep the wine separated on top of the glass
rather than sinking and mixing with the rest of the drink.
It's beautiful,
it's nerdy,
and it's delicious.
While the curds stay behind the filter, the whey goes into the clarified cocktail,
providing a silky, creamy mouthfeel without tasting like milk.
Let me know what you think in the comments.
Boop the like, subscribe, and share buttons.
Please drink responsibly.
We'll see you next time.